G'day friends! Today I'm going to do a very involved art journal spread. It's 3 pages and it was an idea that I don't even remember where I got it from, but I tried it in a little planner insert with some of my digi stamps, and I colored in a few of them and I wanted to stick them down, so I stuck them down on consecutive pages, just kind of staggered a little and then cut the pages out so that they looked like they were kind of standing in a row, kind of behind each other. So I wanted to create a new image and do it with that, and just kind of show how that process happens and how to get that result if that's something you're looking for in your journal. I know some people are a little against cutting up and cutting out pages of your journal, but I think it's really fun. It's a really fun look and it's something different. It's a little interactive, so if you're not into that, then you can just layer these images on one page behind each other, but I'm going to show you this in this tutorial, well, I guess process video, how to do that if you're interested in having them actually staggered and layered over a few different pages. So I've got the image printed out 3 times. It's quite simple, and you know, it's just a head, like a bust, and some crossed arms. I didn't bother putting, you know, connecting the shoulders and the arm, you know, to the arms that I stuck down, because it's a suggestion. Your eyes make the distinction that those are her arms, so, you know, I didn't need to get too literal with it. And I've called it Ladies in Waiting, and just because they all look like they were patiently waiting for something. So yeah, nothing too serious behind it, but basically what you want to do is just cut them out, and you want to glue the first one kind of close to the center, the binding of the book. What is that part called? I always go to talk about that part of the book and I don't know. I'm going to call it the inside seam. You want to stick the first one down there and then trim off the excess to the right hand side of the image. And then you're going to stick the next one down on the next page, just off to the right of the first one. So you can just flip the page back and forth and kind of get your reference of where you want to put it. It looks more effective, I find, if they're right in line with each other. So, I mean, you can stagger them if you want, but it's a little hard to process when you flip the page. So if they're all kind of in the same field, the same plane, on the same plane, you know, right next to each other, you know, the heads, the eyes are lined up, the arms are lined up, it registers better, I find. But you don't have to do that, this is just what I'm doing here. And you want to do the same thing to the third page, just off the second page. So I think it's pretty self-explanatory. If it's not, let me know and I'll try and figure out a better way to say it. But basically you just want to stagger them on the pages and then cut the excess page to the right of the image off. You can do it on the left hand side if you want, but I'm right handed, so I find that it's easier for me to cut it out if it's on the right hand side and the page is formatted like this. But yeah, mine aren't perfectly lined up, but I tried my best. I didn't even do a great job gluing them down. There was glue everywhere, and you know, I was running out of this glue stick, so I was being very conservative. So you'll see when I keep when I finish or put on the finishing touches that I have to re-glue some of those parts down. It's not the end of the world. Kids, if you want to try this, make sure you get an adult to help you with the craft knife or the cutting. I don't want anyone's fingers being chopped off. But yeah, pretty self-explanatory at this point. And you can leave them like that. You can color them before you put them down. I've done that before and it was actually a little easier. But for this purpose, I wanted to show you very simply how they all get aligned in the book, and how you start it and get that effect. So this is how it is. You can leave it like that. You can just journal on them. You can do whatever you want with them. I'm going to color them in and write my little message on there. And I thought it was really fun too, because they're staggered, to have a message going over all 3 of them, but then to try and reinterpret that message on each individual lady. So the message I put over the top was waiting with patience and grace, because that's what they look like they were doing to me. And then I just used the guide of the first one to rule a line down, and any part that was covered by the first image, I could journal behind it and it would kind of be hidden until you open that page. And then I wanted to write another message on that, trying to use the letters that were already down there. It was a little bit of a pain trying to plan it all out, because it had to make sense and it had to work with the letters that were there, but I got it in the end, so that's all that matters. I stuck on a little, like the tiniest little tip in, because I wanted to add an extra letter. So on that woman, she had AIT on her bodice. That's what you see when all of them are laying flat. So I wanted to turn that word into faith. So I put the F behind the part where the first image covers, and then I put the little tip in and I put an H. So now it spells faith. And then I added the AMAZ on this one, or Z, like I like to say. Steve tells me that we don't say Z in America, so it's Z. I put the AMAZ and then turned that word into amazing. And this message in full, on the front it just says waiting with patience and grace. And I strive to do that, but I am very, very impatient. and yeah, so the message underneath on the second girl says, I have faith that even when my patience is tested and I'm quick to anger. And then on the third woman, I said, I am forgiven by his amazing grace. And that's lucky, because I need a lot of forgiveness when it comes to how impatient I can be. But yeah, it's just a really, really nice message that I wanted to have in my journal, and I wanted to have it on a really nice interactive spread so that I'd always go back and look at it and be reminded of that message that, you know, strive to be patient and be graceful about it and be good. But, you know, every time I stumble and kind of get, you know, discouraged or get really upset about something and just want it to be over really quickly, or want to skip all the process that I'm supposed to be learning from, that it's okay. You know, it's not the end of the world if I'm angry about it, but, you know, I need to seek that forgiveness and just pray on it. Let the Lord do the work, because I certainly can't do it myself. So that's the message that I have in there, and yeah, it was really fun to try and figure it out, and very confusing at points, trying to line it all up and make sure that it all worked. But you can put your own message in there and get your mind working on overdrive to see how you can reinterpret your words. But I thought it was just a little fun accent to add to this spread in particular, because it works with hiding things, like hiding hidden messages underneath there. Yeah, so what I'm going to do now is just colour them in. I use Copic markers, I get some Jane Davenport watercolour on there, some Jane Davenport acrylic, I put on a bunch of different decorative elements, I guess. Put some newspaper on there, that's something I'm enjoying at the moment. Also put some washi on there, because it's still me, and I'm still obsessed with washi. But yeah, I'm going to let you just enjoy this decoration process, and I'll come back and do some more voiceover in a little bit. All right, I'm jumping back in for the voiceover. yeah, just been decorating it. I actually don't really have much more to say about how I'm decorating it. It looks like it's just happening. I chose a pretty neutral color palette. Well, I guess neutral by my standards because the whole rainbow isn't on there. But yeah, just warm pinks and oranges and browns. I put the purple in there just for a bit of contrast, just so that they'd stick out a little bit. Obviously, putting my washi tape down there, I can't resist. Always trying to add it somewhere. Using lots of my favorite things. I've been doing those challenges and trying to limit myself with my products lately, so it's nice to it's nice to not have those restrictions anymore and do something with anything that I want to grab from the craft cart. Yeah, so that was very helpful for me at this point. I added those little wings on. They're really cute. Everything in here, I have to say, you'll see it in the close-up, is pretty messy. I was not that interested in keeping it super neat and clean this time. I don't know why. Maybe I've gone a step further with that perfectionist streak and actually just lost the desire to make it neat at all. There's just like a lot of random glue marks everywhere, and just I didn't color, you know, super perfectly. I just didn't really care at this point. I loved the message on it. I loved that it was just free and loose and that it was just playing. This is a fun little accent that I wanted to add to. I wanted it to look like they're all holding the same vine of leaves, I guess. If you connect them, I thought about connecting it, and maybe like when you open each flap, like the having it connected will pull them all up, kind of like an accordion, but I opted against that just because I hadn't really tried it out and I didn't want to get to the end and then actually ruin it, so I made them hold their own little bits of newspaper, and when they're flat it looks like they're all holding it, and when they're not they're just holding little pieces, so that's fine. I you know, you get it, don't you? I thought it would just be a nice way to tie them all together. I love that they're layered. I didn't bother doing anything on the back. Obviously, it's all up to you. If you want to have a go at this, you can get as decorative as you want. There's so much. You're using three pages, so essentially you've got, you know, three pages to decorate, you know, the front and the back. So it can be a little time consuming, but by all means, don't feel pressured to even do anything underneath the overlap. Just leave it blank if you want. But yeah, I wanted to at least color the front parts of it. Maybe I'll go in the back and just do some more journaling, maybe put some more quotes back there. Probably paint it, I don't know. Maybe not, it might just stay like this forever, and I'm not unhappy with that. Because I really like the way it turns out. I think the best part for me was the message, because I really, really needed it. Anyway, I'm going to show you the close-ups. Please be kind, I know it's messy. I know there are glue marks everywhere. I know that I didn't color in the lines. But, you know, it's an art journal. It's just for fun. It's just for play and practice. So, hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Bye.